Some women want to actually wait when it comes down to you. Some women are not into you, so they actually say. When girls are upset, feeling some type of way about something, they're gonna try to keep it very, very simple for the fact that they don't wanna actually explain. They're closing off. What is up, my BS baddies and my bad man fellas? It is your girl Bosana, and welcome B-Boss Army. So as you guys can tell by the title, today I am going to be talking about five lies women tell. Now I already did this video twice, so a lot of the lies that you guys commonly hear, you might not hear in this video, but I promise you guys the ones that I'm going to tell you will still be very, very helpful. But I'm just saying, you guys might comment down other lies that I probably already told on my other video. And also make sure to check out the other videos, because you'll still get more help checking those videos out and figure out more lies that women tell. So you guys already know, make sure you check out my social media, make sure you check out my Patreon. You guys know the videos that go on Patreon, you will not see it on YouTube. And then also you get to see personal life and a whole lot of other stuff that you literally will not see on YouTube. Like I told you guys, if you need more advices, all that good stuff, hop on Patreon. Next thing, of course, is my other second channel. Make sure you check that out, support your girl, subscribe, like, comment on there. And if you already did, thank you guys all so much. And yes, I don't think I'm forgetting. Oh, I can't forget, consultations are back. Also, if you would like to book a consultation, all you have to do is email me and we go straight from there. Okay, you guys, so we're gonna start from five, go down to one. So that means what? You gotta watch until the end to get the number one thing. So number five on my list for five lies women tell is I love or enjoy cooking. A lot of females love to say this, or some other females will say I can cook. Now, because the whole idea of being a wifey is part of being able to cook, girls try to claim that onto themselves so they can look better and seem as if they're actually wifey material. Now, let me say two things. Just because you can cook doesn't mean you're actually wifey material. And just because you can't doesn't mean that you're not. But the thing is, a lot of girls will actually just throw it out there, and then they get taken to the point where it's time to prove that you do, and they actually don't. So it's like, it's just a lie that basically it's a setup. You'll find out, you'll figure it out. But just keep in mind, for other stuff the girls might tell you that is kind of trying to make themselves look good, because there's specific things that will say and feel like, okay, you know what, this is gonna make me look good. But it's just part of the nature. And it goes the same thing for men. A lot of men say certain stuff because they feel like, as a man or alpha male, whatever they want to use the term, they say it so they feel like they are in that category. But just keep in mind how they actually are, their behavior, and you know what is actually their true selves. Okay, so let's move on to the next thing on my list. And number four is I don't mind. A lot of females will say I don't mind, and that's simply because it's just them trying to say I am not mad. But when it comes down to a woman saying I don't mind, I wouldn't say she's as angry as I am not mad, because I don't mind is almost like I'm accepting what you're doing and it bothers me, but I'm gonna tell you it doesn't, so I'm gonna say I don't mind. But what you guys have to do as a man is actually keep asking what the issue is, keep trying to figure it out, what's going on with her, why she feels like I don't mind and wants to leave it at that. And just pay attention to that part right there, leaving it at that. When girls are upset, feeling some type of way about something, they're gonna try to keep it very, very simple for the fact that they don't want to actually explain. They start closing off, so they keep it as I don't mind, I'm not mad, something just so short, trying to just box you out and just, you know, like, leave me alone, I'm angry type of thing right now, but not actually saying that. Okay, so I don't mind is common, but what is more common? I'm not mad. They're basically same thing, like I said, right? So the next thing on my list is number three. And number three is, it's my time of the month. A lot of women love to say this one right here for the simple fact that they don't actually want to be sexually active. Some women want to actually wait when it comes down to you. Some women are not into you, so they actually say that. And it's just all along the lines of they don't want to be sexually active. They don't want to do anything that involves them having to go more passive what is comfortable for them. Okay, so a lot of girls do say that. It doesn't matter what status you're in, doesn't matter if you guys are close, close friends, it really does not matter. Anytime she hits you with that, of course, there's times where it's going to be the truth, but you also have to pay attention to the way you guys are communicating, talking. Like, if it seems like something's off, if it seems like she's been upset, if she seems like she's been distant, anything that seems like it's just off and things are falling apart in a sense, then you're probably going to hear something like that, because it's just like she's not into that. She doesn't want it to happen. So it's going to be her excuse. Okay. So the next thing on my list, this is number two, and it is, I can't talk right now. A lot of females love to hit guys with the I can't talk right now. And this is how it normally goes, just to give you a nice example to understand even better, is that imagine if you are talking to a female, okay? You guys are texting all day. Everything seems pretty good. And even if it doesn't really matter. You decide to give her a phone call. When you decide to give her the phone call, you go to voicemail. And some other females, they really go to a point where they actually will press decline. And you'll know, because the call obviously will not ring through all the way. But whatever it is, she ends up texting you after that and tells you, I can't talk right now. And even if you do get a call where she answers, or you call her and she actually answers, she's still gonna hit you with, I can't talk right now. And it doesn't matter. Like, obviously observe if she's with her family, or there's certain situations where it seems like, okay, legit, she can't talk right now. But there's a lot of girls that are not in that situation at all, and that they are still telling men, oh, I can't talk right now. And that's maybe because your relationship has built around just texting, and it might be a comfort zone thing. But honestly, it's more of a chance of she's not trying to actually be serious or actually talk to you. And she might be doing something that it's like, you know, she's in her own world. Like, you are basically just there, and she's maybe involved with somebody else. Maybe she's still talking to somebody else, or she's even around that person. But it pretty much is a big sign of like, I can't talk to you, and you guys are just in that friend zone, or it's nothing serious at all. So, and even if you guys are serious, pay attention, I told you guys before, to the girls that keep running back to their ex, because in that case, she can also be with that first love that, you know, a lot of females will stick, cling on to around him, and it'll be his time. They're going back and forth. She's with you 1 minute, then she's with him, and it's just like, you're so confused as if she's actually serious with you or not. But it's always, I can't talk right now, I can't talk right now. And everything revolves around her time, because it has to work that way for her to be able to balance out whatever is going on between you and her and that man, that ex-boyfriend, that first love, whoever it is to her, okay? And let's move on to the number one thing on my list. And number one is, we broke up, but we're still friends, okay? This is a very, very common one. Of course, that's why I have to put it as number one. A lot of girls, and I have to keep saying a lot of girls, because it's not every single girl out here. And I didn't say in the beginning, which I said I'm going to start saying in a lot of my videos, because I want people to really understand that there is two different types of females, and there's just a lot of guys really feeling like every single girl is the same. It's just a very, very high chance that they are. But it's the girls that I keep telling that are low quality women, that, you know, have issues of, you know, being broken, or just acting out and not respecting themselves at all as a woman should, okay? So back to what I was saying with, we broke up but we're still friends. Girls that like to get involved with different men, or, you know, have the ex that I just mentioned, still friends. And that's simply because it's like a cover up. So she says that she's still dealing with him. She's still talking to him. She's still running back to him. And she's still telling you, oh, it's done, we're over, all of that. And now maybe she's at a good place, or maybe she has to find a new excuse, or it could just be straight from the jump. She's gonna tell you that that's what she's trying to say with this, that we're still friends. But, you know, you have nothing to worry about. There's nothing to be concerned about, because that's how I look at him. I see him as a friend. Yes, we broke up. We don't have nothing going on. But that's just completely an excuse. Anytime a girl really tells you that, just keep in mind, being a friend with an ex at this point, it's not possible. I know some people can do it, but you have to understand, it depends on the relationship that they had. And these are the serious relationships. Don't expect them to be friends afterwards. It's not going to be just being friends. So if they're telling you what number one is, then they are still involved with them. There is still something there, some sort of feelings, some sort of connection with them, okay? I hope this video helped you guys out. And if you guys have any questions about anything that I said, if you wanted me to elaborate on anything, make sure you drop it down below. Maybe soon I'm gonna do a video just answering a whole bunch of questions or responding back to comments. And like you guys know, make sure you comment down below what other types of videos you like to see and give me a big thumbs up. And so let's finish off with, make sure you check out my social media. Make sure you check out my second channel, support your girl on there, and make sure you check out my Patreon. And you guys will see me in my next video. Bye, you guys.